Last time, we talked about the theory of inflation and how that leads to Max Tegmark's level 2 multiverse. Today, we will be looking at the next level of the multiverse, or the level 3 multiverse, as proposed by Tegmark and some of its defining characteristics. Now, so far, we have looked at structures that we can point to in space, at least in theory. But the next level of the multiverse, the level 3 multiverse, gets super weird. It is believed that the level 3 multiverse is right here all around us, arising from the famous and controversial many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics. The idea that random quantum processes cause the universe to branch into multiple copies, one for each possible outcome. In the early 20th century, the theory of quantum mechanics revolutionized physics by explaining the atomic realm, which does not abide by the classical rules of Newtonian mechanics. Despite the theory's clear triumphs, there is a strong controversy over what it really entails. The theory describes the state of the universe in terms of quantum mechanics, in particular, a mathematical object called a wave function, rather than classical concepts like the locations and velocities of all particles. According to the Schrödinger equation, this state evolves over time in a fashion that mathematicians refer to as unitary, meaning that the wave function rotates in an abstract infinite-dimensional space called Hilbert space. Although quantum mechanics is often described as inherently random and uncertain, the wave function evolves in a deterministic way. So there's nothing random or uncertain about it. The challenge, however, is to connect this wave function to what we observe. Many valid wave functions correspond to counterintuitive situations, such as a cat being dead and alive at the same time in a phenomenon known as quantum superposition. Physicists explained away this weirdness in the 1920s by claiming that whenever someone made an observation, the wave function collapsed into a fixed classical consequence. Although this add-on interpretation had the benefit of explaining observations, it also changed a beautiful unitary theory into a clumsy non-unitary one. The intrinsic randomness commonly ascribed to quantum mechanics is the result of this postulate. Over the years, many physicists have abandoned this view in favor of the one developed in 1957 by Princeton graduate student Hugh Everett III. He showed that the collapse postulate is unnecessary. Pure quantum theory does not, in fact, pose any contradictions, although it predicts that one classical reality gradually splits into superpositions of many such realities. Observers subjectively experience this splitting merely as a slight randomness, with probabilities in exact agreement with those from the old collapse postulate. This superposition of classical worlds is a level 3 multiverse. Now, Everett's many worlds interpretation has been perplexing minds inside and outside physics for more than 4 decades. But the theory becomes easier to grasp when one distinguishes between 2 ways of viewing a physical theory. The outside view of a physicist studying its mathematical equations, like a bird surveying a landscape from high above it, and the inside view of an observer living in the world described by the equations, like a frog living in the landscape surveyed by the bird. From the bird perspective, the level 3 multiverse is simple. There is only one wave function, and it evolves smoothly and deterministically over time without any kind of splitting or parallelism. The abstract quantum world described by this evolving wave function contains within it a vast number of parallel classical storylines, continuously splitting and merging, as well as several quantum phenomena that lack a classical description. From their frog perspective, observers perceive only a tiny fraction of this full reality. They can view their own level 1 universe, but a process called decoherence, which mimics wave function collapse while preserving unitarity, prevents them from seeing level 3 parallel copies of themselves. So whenever observers are asked a question, making a snap decision and give an answer, quantum effects in their brains lead to a superposition of outcomes. From the bird perspective, the act of making a decision causes a person to split into multiple copies, whereas from their frog perspective, each of these alter egos is unaware of the others and notices the branching merely as a slight randomness. Now, it may sound strange, but this is exactly what happens in the level 1 multiverse. But the difference between level 1 and level 3 is where your other copies reside. In the level 1 multiverse, they live somewhere in our regular 3-dimensional space. But in the level 3 multiverse, they live on another quantum branch in infinite-dimensional Hilbert space. Now, the existence of the level 3 multiverse depends on one critical assumption, that the time evolution of the wave function is unitary. Although some theorists working on quantum gravity were initially concerned about unitarity due to the evaporating black holes destroying information, recent discoveries in string theory suggest that even quantum gravity is unitary and that black holes do not destroy information, but simply transmit it elsewhere. So, if physics is unitary, then the standard model of how quantum fluctuations operated early in the Big Bang must change. These fluctuations did not generate initial conditions at random. Rather, they generated a quantum superposition of all possible initial conditions, which coexisted simultaneously. Decoherence then caused these initial conditions to behave classically in separate quantum branches. Here is the critical point. The distribution of outcomes on different quantum branches in a given Hubble volume, level 3, is identical to the distribution of outcomes in different Hubble volumes within a single quantum branch, level 1. This property of quantum fluctuations is known in statistical mechanics as ergodicity. The same reason applies to level 2. The process of symmetry breaking did not produce a unique outcome, but rather a superposition of all outcomes, which rapidly went their separate ways. So if physical constants, space-time dimensionality, and so on can vary among parallel quantum branches at level 3, then they will also vary among parallel universes at level 2. In other words, the level 3 multiverse adds nothing new beyond level 1 and level 2, just more indistinguishable copies of the same universes. But even though the level 3 universe seems to add nothing new, the theory does not end here. Max Tegmark has defined one final level of the multiverse that does add something new to this theory. He calls it the level 4 multiverse. But that is a discussion for another time. If you enjoyed this video, do leave a like, share, and subscribe to our channel for more content ahead. Is our universe truly infinite as predicted by inflation, or just extremely large and finite? Let us know your thoughts down below. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.